tap to the correct timing? How do you tap to the correct timings, and how do you understand the correct season that you're in? Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Sabina, karibu sana. Engineer Tony. Okay. Technocam.
Yes.
Yeah, Engineer Tony, what came into your mind? What came into your mind about the topic?
Okay. When the topic landed to me, I figured it at this point. Season is the moment that you are right now. According to me, I looked at it at that angle, the moment that you current right now. Then of the timing is the things that happen concurrently with the moment that you are. Thank you.
Awesome, awesome. Ninani sijasikia sauti yake. Sawa. Now there's this one person I would want us. Nataka tu kunini, nataka. Eunice, welcome.
Thank you.
Karibu sana.
Thank you.
Hey, it's long. It's been long since nisikia sauti yako. Sawa sawa. Aya. Karanja, welcome. Now.
Thank you.
Karibu sana. Before I welcome Dennis, I won't welcome somebody before I welcome Dennis. And this is a woman that has been so dear to my heart. And mukiona naongea hivi, by the way, ni yeye anafanyanga naongea venye. So tonight I just want to welcome her. And aseme tu maneno mbili tatu because today is a big day for her. Mom, welcome. Hi, Jennifer.
Yay!
Oh. And Jennifer went. Amenitumia text.
Napiganga
let me just go pick Hadassah from her.
Man. How are you?
Fine, mom.
I'm happy.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Karibu sana. Congratulations, mom.
Thank you, thank you. Thank you guys for your support. Mm-hmm. I'm so excited.
Welcome to the world.
Thank you.
Tuambie kama roho yako inafanya du du du.
Today is such a great day.
Sisi tuna celebrate huku tunapiga kelele huku tukiwa tumemute.
And I'm grateful to God. This part is Ebenezer.
Tumekuona kwa TV.
Nasikia nasaidiwa.
Yes.
What?
Somebody is just excited. Mommy did it. Mommy made it. She's also
finally.
Trust me in the middle. So I thank God for you guys. Thank you for your support. So many of you have been so there. And I'm, I don't know, I can't be just excited enough. I thank God, really. So God bless.
You too, man. Sawa sawa. Kwa walio to join, tumekuwa tu tukijibamba na mama yetu. By the way, those who missed Saturday prayers, the men who are there, mshaiona mama yenu akiwekelea mkono. Our mom did that for us. Alifanya hivyo by the way. Mimi hata nilikuwa mtoto hiyo siku. And kuna vitu mingi sana zenye zili happen huko. But don't worry. We will share. I think I've got the teaching. I'll share it to the group so you may hear what exactly was taking place. And it was a center for men, but ladies tapped into the blessings that men were being offered unto. Sawa sawa. Now I want to welcome this young man. He's been away doing the work that God called him to do. And now he's back in Kenya. Karibu sana. Dennis Maina. Sijui kama umerudi.
Umeita babangu young man anyway.
Yeah,
hajawahi kuwa mzee kwangu.
That's the truth. Aging is not a factor.
Mm. Yes.
You don't age.
Welcome, man. Welcome.
Only grow younger.
Mm-hmm.
This is our portion. Isaiah 40, 29 to 31.
Yes.
Go read it. That's our portion.
Yes.
And that's what I prophesy for every one of you guys. Receive youthfulness in Jesus' name.
I receive mine.
I forbid you growing old. Have you ever been forbidden something? I forbid you growing old.
Amen. I receive the forgiveness.
Amen. Sisi tunashinda tu kwa amen kati mimi.
Amen till 90.
Yes. We are going to hit the road. Even as whatever the age. We tell the age, throw your numbers. We don't care.
Yes.
Mom.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes, Adasa also is saying amen.
God is good.
All the time.
God is good.
Nice to see all of you. Irene from Nyeri, please say hi. I think Ronald tried to get you to talk, but ulimnyamazia, say hi. Irene from Nyeri.
She's around.
God, she put on her video. I saw her. Kajua, you're one of the phones you're looking for. It's her.
Jonasema, that phone, oh, that phone disappeared.
Yes. Okay. Must be having trouble. I am not going to put any video on so that if guys are having low bundles, we are not going to spend a lot of your bundles. But I also decree upon everyone that you shall receive bundles for our meetings in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Nakuza umaskini kwa hii team in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
You shall. Amwezi kuwa mnaeka mtumishi nini miguu anaenda kuchapia watu injili na mnaishi vivi. You shall receive blessings in Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 So I'm really excited tonight. I was really looking forward. You know, the other time I was out in Lake Victoria. Goodness, Kenya tunafaa kuamuka. Unajua hawa jamaa wako na cruise ship. Okay, si passe. But wako na meli, mtu anaweza lala. As in unalala kwa meli ukicross. Kenya, God have mercy on us. And they all achieve these things during Magufuli time. Hey, Mungu atukumbuke tu sana.
Tutaimba unikumbuke.
Hey, Kenya, we need to. I traversed that nation from one end to the other. I think I traversed the whole nation. and siku patana na pothole, you can imagine.
Mm-hmm.
And all this was achieved in less than 10 years of Magufuli. I tell you, when the Bible says when the righteous rule, people prosper, it is so true. Mm-hmm. So let me just jump into our topic, because that's the reason why we are gathered. Yes, I congratulate my wife once again for having excelled in her academic. Now she's a completely qualified counseling psychologist, empowered to read. Maybe I encourage you to do an extra mile. I really don't care if you get to be called doctor. Not really. So sky is the limit.
Amen for her. Amen.
Najo to umenyamaza tukashangaa, are you nini congratulating her nicely?
Of course, I'm going to out with some of you tomorrow. So I'm looking forward. in fact, hata leo tukiomba atuombe nini, atuombe kimasomo. Watu wa prospect kimasomo, sindio?
Amen.
Watu wa prospect kimasomo.
Yes, please, amen.
Amen. Tuko hapa wahitaji.
Mm-hmm.
It shall be our portion. Mm? It shall Amen. Be our portion completely.
Amen.
My people perish for lack of knowledge.
Eh?
All forms of knowledge are good. Mm-hmm. Super evil. Be ignorant of evil things. That's the only one I ask you to be ignorant about. Be completely ignorant of evil. Eh? Mm? Thou shalt be poor in... May you get an E in terms of evil.
Amen.
Yeah. E high score. Watu wanapata high score kwa nini, kwa evil. No. That's not our portion. We're not going to.
Mm-hmm.
I hope you're recording this. Some people really couldn't afford the bundles, and they said that you need to record so that you utawarushia in different forms, video, audio, you'll get it. I can see the recording button is on. So let me jump in, people. Let's trust and pray and just welcome the Holy Spirit to minister to us tonight. I am also in expectation. Build some expectation right now. Just throw it in your heart, throw it in your mind, throw it in your head. I expect from you, Jesus. I expect from you, Holy Spirit. I expect that you may transform, speak to my soul, speak to my thoughts, speak to my essence, the situations I'm going through, speak to everything that I am in. So desire him deeply. And I mean it when I say deeply. Desire him deeply. As you experience the cold, may you experience that desire, a deep desire for God, a deep desire for him to minister, to speak to your soul, to just transform every iota of your ideologies, to align you completely. Tonight, Lord, align me, align us, align everyone who will ever listen to this, Let it be an ordained moment for them that, Lord, they are going to receive a metanoia, transformation, change of mind and heart. And that, Lord, we are going to enter into an aspect of understanding. And Lord, I have no words. I do not even know what I'm going to speak out, Lord. I put aside my knowledge. I put aside whatever equipping in the worldly nature I have received, that today I may precisely, accurately articulate what comes from you, King of Glory. My knowledge in this world cannot be equated to the understanding and the knowledge that cometh from you. You as transforms, you as converts, you as changes, you as brings blessings, you as opens doors, you as transforms, and that's what we are in expectation of. And Lord, we thank you and we worship you. Just lift up a worship for a minute. Give you glory, give you honor, give you exaltation, for you are worthy to be praised, worthy to be exalted, worthy to be lifted up. Hail is your name, holy is your name, worthy is your name, and we bless you. Lord, who are we that tonight you have set us apart aside to just minister and to be with us and to just encourage us and to lift us up, oh God? Who are we, Lord, that you have ordained us in the time immemorial, that God has set an appointment for us tonight? that we may be here for you. We worship you. We bless your holy name. And Lord, as our praises come forth, may your blessings come down, Lord. May your blessings come down. May you mix with us, King of Glory. May you transform our inner core. May you transform our thoughts, our actions. May you transform all who we are, where we are, King of Glory. The Lord Jesus, you ordained of this, you ordained of every circumstances that we may be perfectly perpetuated here this evening. Lord, we thank you. We are doing things. Receive all the honor, my God. Receive all the honor. Receive all the honor. Bakasha Darama. I feel the Lord. It's like the Lord was just waiting for you to say, "I worship you," and his presence just fills your space. Like the Lord was just waiting for you to lift up a praise, and he fills your space. And what a beauty this is. What a wonder this is. The Lord, you just waited for me to say, "I adore you," and you fill my space. Lord, make it tangible for someone. Make it tangible. Make your presence tangible for someone. Let someone in their room, in their house, in their with their babies and with whoever is around them just experience you for a moment. Your tangible presence. Lord, I want a tangible filthiness of your presence. Let your glory come down, King of Glory. Let your glory just fill our spaces, Lord. Let your glory. Let it be too much that we need angels to support us. Let it be too much that we need saints to support us. Let it be too much. Let it be too much, Lord. Lord, today we want to soak in your presence. Thank you, King of Glory. Your presence heals. Your presence transforms. Your presence brings glory. In Jesus' mighty and holy name we pray in thanksgiving. Amina.
Amen.
Amina. Are you ready for some word?
Amen.
And I think I had it was Engineer Tony describing the seasons, and also I think I had Didi trying to describe seasons. And you guys are so right. You know, you're so correct. Hey, Ecclesiastes chapter number 3, verse 1-3. And let me say this as I read, as you prepare to read this scripture. Kwa Mungu kuna raha kamilifu. And if you don't experience raha kamilifu, fullness of joy in the presence of God, you want to question your walk. It's important to do questions. Because God does not come to your space to diminish your joy. God does not come into your space to take away your joy. He comes to make it full. I came that you may have joy and joy in its fullness. He does not diminish. And this is, I want us to wake up to the realities of the universe, of this worldly place we are in. They want to create our spiritual life like it is the most boring of events to ever happen to human race. But that is the world's thoughts and that the world's view. But for us who are called unto salvation, we know that God is the most fun being to be ever around. God is the most exciting being to be ever be around. And if you've never experienced excitement in the presence of God, I beseech that tonight the Lord may attack you with it. And if you've never experienced the fullness of joy, I also pray that the Lord may just embrace you with the fullness of joy, that you may know how wonderful and gracious it is to always be in the presence of God. And that's why sometimes I will move away. I will be very technical at times when we meet on Fridays, and I'll be throwing my life coaching skills around. But at times I will also back away and just to be in the presence of God, be in the presence of him that called me in the first place, and relegate everything else, because it is the most beautiful place to be ever completely. He fulfills me, and I trust he fulfills you, and that's why we want to be in his presence every day, that he may be able to fulfill us. So I believe you have turned your Bibles to Ecclesiastes chapter number 3, verse 1-3. And before someone else reads, let me just proclaim it. though I really like when someone else reads so that I know we are together. And I think I also want to hold back. I was up to reading it, but then I want to hold back. Ecclesiastes 3, 1 to 3, someone just read it for us. Let me hold back. And someone to read. So Mary and I know.
Okay, can read.
Go on, Ruth.
Okay. Everything that happens in this world happens at the time God chooses. He sets the time for birth and the time for death, the time for planting and the time for pulling up, the time for killing and the time for healing, the time for tearing down and the time for building. Nisome mpaka wapi? Four.
Verse five. Three only. Yeah, I just needed two verse three. But you can always do your Bible study and continue from there. So, and as this is what most of you are expecting and thought that this is the dimension of things, that they're going to go that way. And I want to start from right there, because I think Solomon happened to be one of the greatest and wisest people to ever grace this God's green earth. And he brings in the seasons that we go through. And I just had someone say, I think it's Pauline. Pauline, my condolences to the family of your beloved intercessor. And it's sad when a man and a woman of God leave earth in a painful manner. We lost, on 5th June, but I really doubt if we lost. Maybe we gained. I don't know if you guys knew Prophet. Alikuwa naitangwa juu huyo jamaa alienda kwa nini.
TB Joshua
was having his partners meeting and retreat, and he happens to tell them, you know, I'm gonna be, you know, some of us are here, they have come, and some of us will leave soon after the meeting. and he was saying he's gonna leave. And guys didn't get it until he just went into his closet, went back to his where he was after the prayers, and he sat on the couch and left and exited the earth in a beautiful manner. You know, those deaths that were we men and women of God, we love to, we would not mind. And So, and when you hear of Pauline's story of a painful death, it can be really traumatizing. It can hit your faith. But there are seasons for everything. There are seasons for everything, even to check out. And how we check out, it really is upon God. Sometimes we will not have the atutakuwa na mamlaka kabisa. It is upon God. God anaweza amua, you're gonna live with a chariot of fire like Elijah. You're gonna walk the way I desire to walk and just be no more like Enoch. But sometimes, you know, we will exit like Jesus, be crucified, like the martyrs of Uganda, be burnt up to death. Sometimes we will have to go through the pain of cancer or other diseases that we know that God can heal. But then the Lord still allows it to happen. And it can be tough. And it can be hard. And I really pray for you, Pauline, and everyone else who experienced that loss, that the Lord is going to encourage you. I remember, I don't know if it's right to say this at this moment, when we lost our firstborn daughter, it was one of those rock bottom seasons for me. And I really desired to be buried. I really wanted to go down and just call it quits. I even decided I'll never really serve God ever again. Like, it's nasty to serve God. He allows very hurtful things to happen. And it was bad. It was really bad. I was a wreck. And the very day I was a wreck, I didn't sleep a wreck. During the barrier, I was a wreck, but I never slept a wreck. Because somehow, between the barrier place and going back to my house, God healed me. And he healed me so deeply that that very day, we were laughing throughout the night. With the guys who hung around me post-burial and they came over to my house. And we were laughing the whole night. And we were talking about things of God. And I was rebuilt. I was deeply, as I had been hurt, so had I been healed. In the same depth of pain, so had, you know, like the way Jesus, the Bible says that in twice have I struck you, and on the third day I would raise you up. And for sure, I experienced the resurrection. I was really, in a new way, born again completely. And this new being that exists today is a new, completely new being. And I have faced many deaths. Yeah? One of the peculiar deaths that some of us are all praying for is the death of your singlehood. When you say, I do, my goodness, that's a death. Let me just speak on behalf of men for a minute. You die. You literally die. Like, hey, it's no longer I that liveth, but my wife. You know, this guy who talks to you is Jennifer, by the way. You really give up who you are. I live for her, like everything I do, you know. Nothing withheld. Because I died to who I was, you know. And these are some of the seasons we are going to have in life. But then what we always anticipate and cry for is beautiful seasons, seasons to blossom, seasons to prosper, seasons to become. Those are the things that we blossom, we run to. But many are the times that we do not know how seasons operate, how timings operate, and how God does all these things. So we become subject. And I know someone, I think Stella mentioned something to do with Queen Esther, and she got lost as she spoke because of the depth of her meditation, that Queen Esther understood who she was and her seasons. But I want to say this right here and right now, that Queen Esther just had knowledge, was well equipped by Mordecai. But I don't think, and I don't imagine, that she really understood completely the aspects of seasons. The only thing is she was equipped. And that's why I want us to, when we are dealing with these seasons and timings, I want us to come from a place of, may you grow up, may you grow in knowledge, may you grow in understanding, so that when the seasons and the timings happen for you, that you are ready for it. Because many are the times that when seasons and timings happen for us, that when a season and a timing happens and we are not ready, that's when we create a missed opportunity. But when we are ready, it doesn't really matter. When the season shall strike, you shall find me ready. And I want you to decree right now a prayer and just pray after me. Say, Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
I am not going to miss any season in my life.
I am not going to miss any
season. I am not going to miss timings in my life.
I am not going to miss timings.
Because you are going to equip me.
Because you are going to equip me.
Tonight and every other day.
Tonight and every other day.
To understand timings and seasons.
Understand.
I am not going to miss timings in my life. Because you are going to equip me. Tonight and every other day. To understand timing and seasons.
Thank you and amen to all of you. We receive in Jesus' name, because he's going to be the one to help us. Understand this. Everything that happens in this earth, and allow me to enlarge earth by declaring there are so many parts of the universe. There are so many planets. Anything that happens in the universe operates in seasons and timings, courtesy of how the creation happened. What happened in Genesis chapter 1? The earth was formless, and then the Lord spoke. It is unto speaking that he ushered in creation. In the likeness of heaven was earth created. So the beauty of earth is superimposed over the beauty of heaven. And more so now that we are busy destroying earth, heaven, on the other hand, is not being destroyed. So it still will be magnificent, and we will see extremely wonderful things when we get there. But here on earth, it is our jurisdiction, courtesy of we are men created of the image and likeness of God, and so we affect our universe because it is granted to us. It is given to us to operate. This is our dominion. This is our domain where we can exercise. So when God creates the universe and he himself ushers in the seasons. And how does he usher in? By introducing a factor called time. A factor called time is when he creates day and night, and then he even releases a sun to guard the day and the moon to guard the night. And so immediately in scripture it says it was night and it was day. So meaning that immediately he ushers in, he creates time, means that earth cannot now operate in terms of eternity, but has an expiry date. That's why earth shall be destroyed, but the destruction only came courtesy of human failure or our falling. But it would not have been destroyed if we didn't fall. So eternity, God operates in eternity, but seasons and timings he created for us to operate in, so that there is a time for everything. So meaning that day and night, 24 hours of a day, they come, they go. And it is in the timings that also you bring in seasons, because seasons now cover a wide area of time. Seasons cover a wide area of time. But time is limited, is limited. Yeah, we can say that we have 24 hours in a day. So, and it is distributed between being awake and also being asleep, activity and inactivity. Our inactivity produces energy for our activity. And that also is a very important factor that we need to understand. So even as we are in the presence of God, there are moments of activity and there are moments of inactivity. And we will also experience the same thing in our relationship with God, that there are some moments he is very active with us and some moments he will be inactive with us. And most of the time, the devil is in the details. The devil wants to creep in during the inactivity times, when things are not, God is not maybe saying, God is not talking, God is not active in our lives, then we tend to think that God is not present. But I want to refute that ideology by reminding you the scenario of examination. During exam period, have you ever seen your class teacher or the teacher who taught you anything trying to inform you, to talk to you? The teacher is silent, completely silent. The person who gave you all the knowledge that you're supposed to produce during an exam is completely silent. But does that mean that the teacher is not present? No, it's only that it is your period to express that which you have learned. So the silence and the inactivity of God does not negate that he is present with us. On the other hand, always remind yourself, he said that I shall never leave you nor forsake you till the end of the earth, meaning that he shall speak and remain with you. So should you ever feel at any moment or in time that God is not with you, it is your mind playing tricks on you, courtesy of erroneous information from the devil. So you, it is for you now to remind yourself, and that's why we store scriptures in our minds, so that in times and seasons of temptations and trials, that we can be able to speak back those words. And that, and Jesus himself became the practical example that when his season of temptation came in Matthew chapter 3 and also Luke chapter 3, immediately after baptism, he walks into the wilderness, into the inactivity of God. He goes into inactivity of God, where God is not actively ministering or talking to him. And the last words God had spoken was, "This is my beloved son with whom I am well pleased." And then immediately after, and sometimes that's what we experience. Some people come into the presence of God and they are like, "Hey, hey, kwa Mungu ni kuno mare. This is how things..." You know, and some come into the presence of God and walk into honeymoon. So it does. There is no hakuna template. Hakuna template ya kusema, this is how it's gonna be. All you need, the only template, is you are with God, and He will never leave you nor forsake you. That needs to stick into your head. And so that when so for you to be able to handle seasons, you need to have that knowledge. So, Aya, now let's go into the fall. Because I want to now bring you how the other strong message about seasons that God brings in. Genesis, when you go into chapter 6, there is absolute failure. Even after releasing Adam and Eve to not go to near the Garden of Eden, they wanazaa watoto and they experience so much growth in themselves as in multiplication as human beings, they still are suffering from the repercussions of sinfulness. And so by Genesis chapter 6, we even have angels coveting women on earth, and they are called the Nephilim. They come down to earth to make love to women, and they even bore giants, the tribe of the Nephilim. So God is so angry that he regrets creating. And so he speaks unto Noah, and says, "Go ye and create for me." Now, because in this world, human beings are, it's the domain of the human beings. So he needs a man every time he needs to redeem. He needs a man every time he needs to bring in a season. He needs a man every time he, you know. So he brings in Noah into the picture and tells him, "Do A, B, C, D, create an ark, and I want you to help me to save this world, whoever will listen." And so, kama kawaida, watu ni vichwa ngumu, wanapenda raha za dunia peke yake, hawajui raha kamilifu ni ya Mwenyezi Mungu. They allow themselves to enjoy the small freebies of the earth, and they get swallowed in the floods. And Genesis chapter 8, my storyline again. Now, there we need to turn our Bibles. Genesis chapter 8. The floods are over. Noah and his sons and their wives and his wife are out, and they are offering sacrifices to the Lord. And the Lord declares something very important for us as we reflect on timings and seasons. Somebody read chapter 8, verse number 22. The Lord declares these words when he receives the sacrifice from Noah. Anyone who's there? Genesis 8:22. Come on. Put aside your Bible, did you?
I read.
Go on.
As long as the world exists, there will be a time for planting and a time for harvest. There'll always be cold and heat, summer and winter, day and night.
As long as the world exists, you need to take your felt pen or your highlighter and highlight those scriptures. And I pray that those scriptures will hit you every single day, that you will be able to understand what God was saying. That nothing will ever happen on earth. Mistake. Everything that will happen on earth is intended and precise. And it is a result of two things: a seed and a harvest. And I dare say this: the life we are experiencing individually, collectively, communally, is a harvest of what was sown in the past. If we are experiencing joy, goodness, happiness, it did not fall from the sky. It was intentionally planted, and that's why you are reaping. So there is no harvest without planting. And this season shall remain till the end of the earth. Seed time and and reaping time. So if we see nasty and negative things happening to us, surrounding us, they were planted. And I want us to remember the story that Jesus gave about a farmer who went and planted wheat and was so excited about farming and planting and went to sleep. And the Bible says, as he slept, the enemy came and planted chaff in the same land. And so when the time came for harvesting, there was both chaff and wheat. And you know, chaff is almost, it's a lookalike of wheat. And therefore the Lord says, do not uproot. It was necessary not to uproot because you might not know what you are uprooting. So it is in the harvesting time that some went for being consumed by fire, while some went being consumed for the rightful purpose. And so we are both planters and consumers of time and seasons. So whatever we sow, we end up reaping. And let me say this also, let me add this to spanner to the works, is that some of the sowing we are reaping, we did not plant. Let me come again. Some of the reaping, some of the harvesting that we are going through, we did not plant. But out of whether it was ignorant on our side or not, we still reap a harvest. Meaning that if the enemy came in the night and planted, kama tulilala ama tulikuwa tumeamka, a small, our own problem. So God says, you know, it did not stop it from kumea, haikuzuilika kumea. It still had to come to be because it was planted. Because here on earth, that's what happens. Seasons and timings are places and dimensions for sowing. So right now, as we, most of us have already done and some of us are doing, we are doing, my prayer for a partner was, it's a sowing business. And this is a deep secret that some of you stumbled upon, and maybe some of you have not even come to a revelation or realization that you are suddenly now, you are deliberately sowing into your future. That you are becoming an active participant unto the harvest you shall reap. You see, this is not wishful thinking. Let's run away from wishful thinking. People who do not understand seasons and timings operate in wishful thinking. And that's why we are not able to plant faith. Because in wishful thinking, you say, oh, I am hoping for a good husband. I am hoping for a good wife. I am hoping for a good job. I am hoping for a wishful thinking. But when you know timings and seasons, you stop operating in that mentality and you become deliberate about your actions. You become intentional. You do things that you are going to reap exactly what you're sowing. So meaning that every actions that you're doing today, you're setting up yourself for a favor tomorrow or setting up yourself for a failure tomorrow. Every step and actions that you are partaking of today, you are setting yourself. Let me say this. You cannot be waste. You cannot spend any second in the presence of God, and you do not reap a harvest in your future. That has never been the story of heaven, unless he did not say those words himself, that as long as earth exists, there shall be sowing time and reaping time. So seasons are there to allow us to sow. And that's why you will see that there are times when we need to accrue. There are times, and I want us to bring you to, so that we understand seasons and timings. So Ecclesiastes tells us what happens in these seasons. But then what to do with the seasons is also important. What do we do with these seasons? And I want us to turn to the book of Jeremiah, chapter number 1. And this time we are not going to read verse 5 alone. We are going to read verse 5 all the way to 10, so that we understand when seasons happen, what are we supposed to do with the seasons? So that we know what is required of us. Is it a time for sowing? Is it a time for harvesting? What is it? And so that now I can finish up with identifying. So what to do with the seasons? Aya, nani amefika? Jeremiah? Jeremiah 1:5-10.
I read.
Thank you.
Jeremiah 1:5-10.
Uh-huh. What to do with the seasons? Uh-huh.
Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Before
clarity
you were born,
of intentionality. So you are planted into this earth. No mistake, no error. Uh-huh. Continue.
Before you were born, I dedicated you.
Uh-huh.
A prophet to the nations. I appointed you.
Mm-hmm.
Ah, Lord God, I said, I do not know how to speak. I am too young. But the Lord answered me.
Take this as the excuses we throw to the Lord.
Mm-hmm. Do not say I am too young.
Mm-hmm.
To whomever I send you, you shall go. Mm-hmm. Whatever I command you, you shall speak. Mm-hmm. Do not be afraid of them. For I am with you to deliver you, oracle of the Lord. Then the Lord extended his hand and touched my mouth, saying to me.
And I pray that our mouths are going to be touched, because these are the instruments to really operate the seasons. Go on.
See, I place my words into your mouth.
Mm.
Verse 10.
Mm-hmm.
Today I appoint you over nations.
Uh-huh.
And over kingdoms.
This is our domain. This is our domain. Uh-huh.
I repeat, today I appoint you over nations and over kingdoms to uproot and to tear down, to destroy and to demolish, to build and to plant. And that's the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. I pray that you really get this word. Whatever seasons the Lord releases into your life, the method of operation is Jeremiah 1:10. You need to understand what season you are in. If it is an ugly season and things are not working out for you, then you need to check out if there is a tool to deal with the situation. And you might need a tool called uprooting. You need to uproot what is happening in your life. And you see, this is not a time for depression. And that's why in the kingdom of God, depressions are not, those are not our stories. Because for every season, there is an action that is required. So if you're going through an attack and you're facing attacks, maybe it is at work, maybe it is in your business and things are just not working. Things are failing. Maybe it is your time. You need to understand that you're going through a season of tough times. A season of attack. What is required? Then you need a weapon. You need to. That is your season for fighting. That is your season for saying, you know, the battle does not belong to me. The battle belongs to your wakati. Maybe madhabahu yamekuwa yakikunenea. Maybe demons have been released from the gates of heads to attack your life, and you need to arise in the rightful attitude for the season, and know that I am in a season of warfare. So I need to. When we miss our seasons, that's the unfortunate thing. That is when we fall into sins and a lot of temptation. Let me give you an example. King David, in the season, the Bible says, in the season when kings were going for war, King David, having won so many wars, was left behind. So as he was left behind, the women knew that all our men have gone for war. So Uriah's Sheba, Bathsheba, was out just doing her bathing in the open pool, knowing that there are no men around. I mean, they have all gone to war. Little did she know that King David had absconded the season of war and was not in the war. So he was busy seeing this naked woman and enjoying himself. And he fell into the temptation, brought her in, and the rest is history. God is good. And I want you to see even the moments you fell into temptations, all the relationships you got yourself in, you missed your season. You missed the timings of what was happening to you. So, and you are caught up in the temptation. You are really caught up. The environment was, you misread every, what do we call them? Uli misread cues, all the cues, and you fell into the temptation, courtesy of not understanding the season you are in. So we need to know which seasons we operate in so that we can know, am I going through a season of temptation like Jesus? Then I need to be equipped with scriptures to say, it is written, and be able to pull out of these things. Am I going through a season of, you know, I remember in one of the classes I was able to teach about counterfeits. Am I going through a season of counterfeits where I am receiving counterfeits before my original giftings? And if it is during those times, it is your time for resistance. It is your time to say no. And it is your time to remember what the word of the Lord says, resist the devil and the devil will flee from you. So, but when we don't understand these things of timings and seasons, we tend to flirt with the wrong things. We tend to flirt with the wrong time of things. And that's why even the very people who are Pharisees and scribes, having studied scripture, and I want to say this, scripture alone will not assist you. When you do not have ushiku mkono na the right person, you might read a lot of scripture then, and they might lead you astray. The Pharisees and scribes, they knew that the Lord will be born. They knew all those things, scriptures that were written. But without the voice of prophecy, they were going to miss. They missed the opportunity. They missed the season. Jesus hung around and they really missed it because they did not hear the voice of prophecy. And let me say these words so that you will also understand clearly. Now I have given you the tools. The tools, we are going to get them from Jeremiah 1:10. And I have told you about the seasons that we have gotten from Ecclesiastes 3:1-3. Now, what we need to get is, while the earth remains, seed time and harvest time, meaning cold and heat will always be, summer and winter will always be, day and night will always be. And as long as you have lived, you know that these things have been existing. So, for everything, there is a season. And a time for every purpose under heaven. Even a time to get married. I will not say divorced. Maybe death. Yet without prophetic scripture, alone cannot help us. It is the realm of the prophetic that seasons are understood. If you read the book of Genesis all the way to Malachi, it is the prophets that were able to guide people through. Even the kings were guided by the prophets, you know, because there was a prophetic word that had been said. And I want to usher you people to a place of understanding prophecy, because it is when we understand prophecy that we are corrected and things operate as they are supposed to be. You see, post Jesus, prophecy was upon individuals. Yeah, pre-Jesus, prophecy was upon individuals, Isaiah, Amos, Malachi, all those prophets that existed. post Jesus, now after Jesus has come into earth and people can receive salvation through him, and he releases his spirit, meaning the same spirit that he had operates on everyone who receives the Lord, meaning that the gift of prophecy has been released upon everyone. Of course, there are some that will operate in it and in a bigger way than others. But prophecy comes in to usher season. So meaning that you may be going through a season that is ugly in your life, and you have been fighting battles that are never ending. Wars after wars, nightmare after nightmare, whatever attacks after whatever attacks, delay after delay, rejection after rejection, problems after problems. But then you get tired of it. And then you tell the Lord, Lord, I need a word. And the Lord releases a prophetic word upon your life and ushers you in into a new season. And that's why the earth was shapeless. But immediately the word of the Lord, Jesus himself, who is prophecy in incarnate, prophecy in himself, he is released, and the word was released, and the shapeless earth started taking form. So it is the word, when it is released, that anything happens. And that's why John understands this prophetic idea, angle of things, and moves away from Mark's way of scripture, moves away from Luke's way of scripture, and brings a new form. And he says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He understands that if we see things from the word aspect of things, then things are going to be aligned properly. So some of you tonight, your life is going to be aligned because God has released a prophetic word in my tongue that you season, we're going to change your season. A season of failure, we are ushering a season of success. A season of crying, we are ushering a season of happiness. A season of tears, we are ushering a season of being consoled in the name of Jesus Christ, because a prophetic word is going to be released to us tonight. And that's why sometimes some seasons have remained for a long time. Drought has remained, rejection has remained, because no prophetic word was released. And when Jesus steps into the scene, it is the prophetic that allows us to know God's purpose for a particular season. So our prayers and actions can come into agreement that we are not pulling against the will of God the Father. Because we, by virtue of knowledge of scripture, can still know scripture and pull away from God. How many people have offended God yet they know God? It is when a prophetic word is released upon your life that the Lord fixes your face. The Lord wants to bless you, that you want to align yourself. But until the word is released into your life, you never align. And that's why mimi napenda saa zingine, we be at a place whereby word ya Mungu inapasuliwa in the spirit, inapasuliwa kwetu powerfully. Because when the word of God is being inapasuliwa ama inamegwa in a powerful manner, the prophetic is released into people's lives and change comes. That's why how healings happen. The Lord would speak a word and healing would follow, because the word was prophetic. It was speaking to a condition of sickness, but because the word is prophetic, it is declaring that which is not. The condition is sickness, but the word is declaring prophetically, when you're sick and you're seeking healing, it's like healing is up in a prophetic dimension, because you're not having healing. So when someone says you are healed, it is a prophecy. It is a prophecy. You are healed, meaning that now you can rise in faith, connect with the word that has been released, and then you receive your healing. So when I speak God's word in spirit, it connects with your faith, and your faith comes up higher, and you're able to say, yes, I am going to be married. Yes, I am going to receive my job. Yes, my doors are going to open. That's why a prophetic word is key in ushering in seasons. So get this now. Let me give you a very practical example from scripture. This woman who had the issue of blood that is quoted in, is it Mark chapter 5? you know, Jairus was going to get Jesus to go bring healing to the daughter, but Jesus, in the while proceeding, gets touched by a woman with an issue of blood. But the beautiful scripture says, you know, she spoke to herself, if I would only touch the hem of his garment. Where was she getting this knowledge from? She must have heard the old scriptures of Malachi chapter number 4, verse 2, that he who comes will carry healing in his wings. The same as the mavazi zile za manabi ama rabbis were wearing, they had some fleeces at the very end. And this was the type of hem that was on Jesus' garment. And she knew the scripture, that the scripture says that he who will come will bear healing in his race. And he's able to activate that word with faith and say, I will touch the hem of his garment. And perfect timing ushers in a new season for the woman. 12 years having shed blood nonstop, having lost every single penny to her name. Maybe she even lost her marriage for that matter. But the moment she touches the hem of the garment, perfect timing, perfect word, she's ushered into a new season of no more bloodshed. And tonight I want to pray, and I will give us even time to ask questions, so that in case we have not understood anything, we can be able to understand. Is God wants to release this word to you. Some of you, your marriage is going to be released because a word is going to be released tonight. You've been going through a period of rejection, but the Lord sent me to tell you, your season of acceptance has come. You've been going through a series of heartbreaks, but the Lord sent me to tell you that your healing has come. God is going to patch your future for his purposes. See, the Lord does not release spouses for us to just enjoy. He releases spouses to align themselves, to align you and the spouse with the vision and mission he has for you. See, sometimes when we miss the reason and the purpose of God releasing a spouse in our lives, we end up not even having one. Because you see, a marriage is not an end. It is a means to an end. Our work here on earth is not an end. It is a means towards an end. Some of us have been positioned as businessmen and should business persons for that matter, so that you may amass enough resources to ensure that the kingdom of God is spread without problem, that the men and women of God that God raises will lack in nothing. And as long as they lack, your business misses out on purpose. And therefore, God may reach a place whereby he thinks, you know, why then am I releasing a blessing if it is not meeting my ends, if it is not meeting my needs? See, we are not called like the people of the world, that this is the end in itself, that this our life ends here. As we are called, these seasons and timings are supposed to usher us into eternity. So we are here for a moment. So everything that we do is supposed to gear us up and to set us up for the glory of God that is coming, for the heavenly blessings that we are going to operate in. So meaning that we operationalize a little heaven down here. We create a little heaven down here as a premonition of where we are going to go. So if we are already living in hell, people are going to miss out on living in heaven, because we who represent the kingdom of God are misrepresenting facts. And how do we misrepresent facts when we keep on missing our season, when we keep on missing timings? So God is today elevating all of us into a place of prayerfulness, meditation place, where we will be understanding the seasons and doing exactly that which you're supposed to do. If we are in a season of harvesting, it's not a season for planting. It's for receiving and reaping and storing and being able to do the great works of heaven. And if we are in a season that is low,
It is a season of planting. It is a season of preparing for a great harvest in the future. So whatever seasons we are in, God has orchestrated them. God has intended them. But do you understand? Do you know that you are aware? You sat down with the Lord and he has been able to reveal scriptures to you and told you this is the time you're going through. So when we miss out on this information, we misinterpret things. We misinterpret even pain. You will think of Jesus hanging on that cross. If he had not been informed prior. You see, and that's why I want us to understand today, Amos 3:7. Amos 3:7, the Lord says that he does, surely the sovereign Lord does nothing without revealing his plan to his servants, the prophets. Meaning that sometimes even a child or someone may walk to you and tell you something that resonates to what you have been meditating or going through. And you need to capture those moments quickly and know that it is the Lord releasing a prophetic word. You see, prophecy today is not like in the old times. The old times, they may not have known what the Lord is saying. And so the prophet was like the sole bearer of what the Lord is saying. But in today's time, courtesy of the Holy Spirit, if I should speak this word of the Lord unto you prophetically, it is something that is already ongoing within you. And that's how you know whether it is from the Lord or not. Because if it is not from the Lord, he's not doing anything in you with it. He's not speaking in you. So you can easily say, okay, that was not my word. But if it is a season and a thing you're going through, and then you hear a word that is exactly in line with what you're going through, you better know that that's the voice of the Lord. And you need to take an action that is required. You need to take an action that is necessary so that you can be able to usher in a new season into your life. I hope you have received what the Lord has for you. And before we go into a place of prayer, I want to open up for Mneza Uliza Maswali, Moja Mbili, where someone feels like you need clarification, need further explanation. I am here and I am going to listen. Talk of having God's word and being able to ask questions. Silence means all understood. So do we go into prayers direct? Welcome, Mary. Understood. Any questions going once? Oh, wonderful. Ella says, all understood. I thank you, Holy Spirit, for releasing the grace of understanding. So are you ready for some prayer? And tonight I am going to release that prophetic word over every one of us. I don't know what seasons you're going through, but the Lord is about to just shift. I don't know who's shifting the season. So some of us are not going. No, it's not for everyone. But some of us require a shift of season. And tonight is that night where the shift happens. Because a word is going to be released over your season and things are going to turn around in the name of Jesus Christ. Rama Shandara. So just leave your place of comfort for a minute. You know our system, guys. You know our system. Leave your place of comfort for a minute. It's cold enough. Just step on the floor. And then let's just give the Lord a deserving worship, a deserving time of prayer, and that he may come down and just release a grace upon us, a prophetic word upon our lives. Rabba Baba, he said that we give you glory, we give you exaltation, Holy One of Israel. We adore you, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Listen to our joint prayer, Lord. We are coming, we are gathered here as Matthew 18:18 says, the 2 or 3 meet in my name, I am there with them. So you are here with us, King of Glory. And the beauty of it is that you are omnipresent. So you are equally in my house as in you are in everyone's house here. You are equally in my presence as you are. You're equally with every one of us. And so we worship you, Lord. Give you glory, give you exaltation, King of Kings, Lord of Lords, we adore you. We lift your name on high. We lift your name on high, King of Kings. Blessed is your holy name. Glorious is your holy name. Rima Shandara, be exalted, Holy One of Israel. Just whatever comes to you praise him in your own way. You worship him in your own way. Let not a song hinder you. You can sing a song in his presence. You can give him a shout if you feel like doing that, but just do it in your own method, at a place of not comfort. In the name of Jesus Christ, we thank you. We adore you, my Jesus. I lift you up on high. I adore you. I exalt you, Holy One of Israel. Be exalted, Holy One of Israel. I magnify your holy name. Lord, as my feet do the walks around my house, King of Glory, let your presence minister to this house. As my hands do a lifting in this house, King of Glory, lay receive my praises, Holy One of Israel. Receive my praises, King of Glory. As my voice vocalizes your praises, King of Glory, let the walls be soaked by your presence. Let my house be soaked by your presence. Rima, kaba, shakaba, yokomo, sindarara. That, Lord Jesus, tonight is our night, Lord, where you usher in a season of perfection, King of Glory. Rakaba, sandara. Lord, I still thank you that, Lord, we are in the month of perfection. The Lord, you're perfecting your will of our lives, Lord. I give you glory. I give you exaltation, Holy One of Israel. Thank you for your love. Thank you for your mercies. They are new every morning, my God, my God, my God. They are new every morning. You allow us to stand in your presence and we are not smitten. We are not killed because, Lord, you love us. You treasure us so much that you gave up your life, Jesus, that we may have the presence of the Lord perpetually. Be exalted, Holy One of Israel. Be magnified, my God. Be lifted up on high, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. You are worthy, Lord. You are worthy, King of Glory. You are worthy, Holy One of Israel. You are worthy, Lord. We lift your name on high. We exalt you, mighty God. We magnify you, Holy One. We lift you. Blessed be your holy name, Lord. Oh, I join the cherubims and seraphims, Lord, to just say, holy, 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 holy is your name. Holy are you, Lord, King of hosts. Holy, 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 holy. Exalted are you, Lord. Magnified are you, Lord. And Lord, I want to be lost in your presence, Lord. Your presence is everything to me, Lord. Your presence is everything to me, Lord. Holy, 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 holy is your name, my God. Tonight, Lord, you sanctify our tongues, Rama, Mama, Mama, that they may worship you, Lord. Tonight, you sanctify our thoughts, that they may lift you all the times. Tonight, you sanctify our hearts, that we may lift up a holy worship to you, Lord. Rima, Mama, Mama, receive all the glory, God. Receive all the honor, receive all majesty, receive all praise, receive, 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 my God, receive it, King of Glory. Oh, we are privileged to be in your presence, Jesus. We are privileged to be in your presence, my God, my God. Let your presence flow. Let your presence flow. Let your presence flow. Oh, minister to us tonight, oh God. Minister to our very points of needs, my God. Lord, somebody is going through rejection tonight, is going to find acceptance. Father, tonight somebody is going through pain and Lord is going to find healing in your presence. Tonight somebody is going through a lot of loneliness. King of Glory is going to find fulfillment in you, oh God. And Lord, we swim in your presence. We swim in your presence, oh God. We adore you, King of Glory. Lift your name on high. Be exalted, Holy One. Be exalted, Mighty One. Be magnified, oh, worthy is your name. We never grow weary in lifting you up, oh God. We never grow tired, oh God, to be in your presence and to say, worthy is the best thing that can happen to me, my God. And I'm glad I am here, Lord, to say, worthy is your name, Lord, without lifting a heart or desiring for you to just bless me. I just want to just adore you and just be in your presence, Lord, without asking you for anything, Lord. I just want to be in your presence, Lord. Fill me, soak me up, oh God. soak me up, soak my house up, oh God, soak my bed, soak my sitting room, soak everything about me, Lord. Let it be soaked in your presence, oh God. Let me experience you every moment of my life. Soak my business, soak my work, soak my ministry, soak everything with your presence, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. We adore you, Jesus. Be exalted, oh God. Holy, 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 holy is your name. Holy, 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 holy is your name, my God. Holy is your name. I know in your courts, King of Glory, I find favor. I find favor because of your mercy, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. And I want us to take a few minutes to just repent. You know where you have fallen short of God's glory. Just take a few minutes and just repent and just ask the Lord to cleanse you. Father God, we stand in your presence, seeking also a cleansing of your precious blood. The Lord, let your precious blood speak better words for me, Lord. Cleanse me, King of Glory, from every speech that I have spoken that has hurt, offended someone, King of Glory, where I have promised things that I never fulfilled, King of Glory. I seek your repentance, Lord. Come on, just repent before our good God. Repent and let there be a cleansing happening in our hearts. Lord, we want a change of heart and mind, King of Glory. Cleanse us from pride. Cleanse us, Lord. Cleanse me from any lack of humility, King of Glory. Cleanse me from any lies that have proceeded from my mouth, King of Glory. Every moment, Lord Jesus, that have brought you shame, King of Glory, I repent, my God. I repent, my God. Every ignorance, oh God, laziness, Lord, I repent of every one of it, oh God, King of Glory, that as I stand in your presence, Lord, you purify me, Lord. You make me whole again, oh King of Glory. Thank you for your forgiveness, Jehovah, my Jesus. Let's receive the forgiveness of God in thanksgiving. Lord, I thank you for forgiving me. I thank you for cleansing me. I thank you for purifying my heart and my mind. Thank you, my God, you're releasing me from, I am no longer guilty. I am not condemned. In the presence of God, I am forgiven. I am a child who's loved and forgiven, loved and blessed, loved and blessed. Rama mama. And right now, I want to release the Spirit of God upon every one of our tongues. Come on, desire the Spirit of God, because I'm going to use your words, the words that the Lord is going to place in your tongues. Today, you're going to be fired up like Jeremiah. Your tongue is being touched to speak forth God's word like Isaiah. We've been touched by the call from heaven. We are purified. Our tongues have been purified. And the Lord wants to use our very mouths to prophesy of our lives. Ramamama, Kiribu Shandara. Spirit of God, come upon us. Come upon our tongues. Come upon our lives. And give us the right words to usher in a season of favor in our lives. And come on, just begin to open your mouth and decree upon your life a season change. If you're going through a situation that has been nasty, this is your moment now. The Lord has empowered you with his Spirit to begin to speak in the name of Jesus Christ. I decree a season of favor over my life, King of Glory, a season of promotion, King of Glory, a season of ushering in new things, King of Glory. Rakamasa, over my life, Lord, I release over them that are under my voice, Lord. The Lord Jesus, every desire that they have been going through that is in line with your words, oh God, the Lord, let it be fulfilled, King of Glory. Lord, them that are believing and trusting you for spouses, I decree them in the name of Jesus Christ. Purposeful spouses, oh God, supportive spouses in the name of Jesus Christ, let there be a release. Every rejection, I nullify you right now in the name of Jesus Christ. I put an end to every rejection. I release a moratorium in the spirit that no more rejection is coming our way in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, except that which is to glorify the Lord. But any other, I nullify your action and activity over our lives in the name of Jesus Christ. Let there be a release and acceptance. I release a season of acceptance. I release a season. Nafukuza. Season ya ku attract watu wabaya katika maisha yetu, bad relationships. In the name of Jesus Christ, I disconnect that. I disconnect that in the name of Jesus Christ. And I release a season of attracting wonderful people in our lives great people in our lives because they are there, but the enemy has made sure that we are not going to meet them. But now I decree connection in the name of Jesus Christ, connecting with the right people, connecting with the right people in the name of Jesus Christ. I disconnect everyone under the sound of my voice from connecting with negative people, from connecting with demeaning people, from connecting with people who want to rudisha nyuma. In the name of Jesus Christ, I release rightful connections, rightful relationships, the kingdom relationships in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, kingdom relationships in the name of Jesus. Rabba. In the name of Jesus, be released. Be released right now. Be released. I release a season of abundance for someone who's been going through scarcity. I nullify, I put an end to scarcity in the name of Jesus Christ. Lack and scarcity, I put an end in the name of Jesus Christ. And I release a spirit of abundance, overflow in the name of Jesus. Come on, come on, in the name of Jesus. If you've been going through a season of scarcity, I want to decree, I am walking into abundance. I am walking into abundance. I don't care how many times you repeat, but repeat as much as you want, but repeat by faith. I am walking into abundance. I am walking into abundance. I am walking into a season of abundance, of overflow. Overflow, overflow in my season, overflow in my season, in the name of Jesus Christ, overflow, 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 katika jina la Yesu Kristu, riba baba baba, in the name of Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus Christ, overflow, 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 rababa, in the name of Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus Christ, rakaba sandarara, in the name of Jesus Christ, overflow, 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 season of overflow. Someone is going through scarcity. Come on, decree, decree. The Spirit of the Lord has touched your mouth. Now release abundance into your own life. In the name of Jesus Christ, I release a season of abundance. Abundance in the name of Jesus Christ. Overflow in the name of Jesus Christ. Hey, Ramama, in the name of Jesus Christ, I disconnect everyone who's going through a season of loneliness. Loneliness, your time is up. Your time is up. I release a time of fulfillment in the name of Jesus Christ. No more loneliness in the name of Jesus Christ. We are going to be fulfilled in the presence of God, and we are going to find fulfilling relationships in the name of Jesus Christ. Fulfilling relationship, tunaenda kutosheleka na kuwa wakamilifu. Mahali tunajihisi ya tuko wakamilifu. A season ya kukamilika. Season ya kukamilika katika jina la Yesu Kristu, katika jina la Yesu Kristu, release a season of kukamilika, kutosheleka. In the name of Jesus Christ, be glorified, O God. Be exalted, my Holy One. Be lifted up, O Holy One. And someone is going through a season of confusion. I decree every confusion. Kuchanganyikiwa. Mawazo hisia katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Vunjika. Confusion vunjika. Raba baba ba shandarari kiria raba. Yema sandarari kiriri. The name of Jesus Christ. Vunjika confusion. Vunjika confusion. And we release in our lives a season of clarity. Come on, decree clarity over your mind and over how you do things, how you operate. Clarity. No more confusion. No more confusion. Clarity. In the name of Jesus Christ, clarity. Clarity. Clarity of purpose. Clarity of vision. Clarity of intention. Intentionality. Clarity. In the name of Jesus Christ, we release a season of clarity. Tunaenda kupokea clarity. Clarity. Utajua. Eh, watu wamekuwa kihata season zao because they are not clear. They are confused. During their season, they are confused. When they are supposed to take an action, they don't take an action because they are confused. I release great of clarity. Utajua what to do. From tonight, you're going to know what to do, how to do it, when to do it. You're going to know how to do it, when to do it, how to do it. In the name of Jesus Christ, you know, clarity, 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 clarity. Your vision is being clarified now. Spirit of God, receive clarity of vision. You will live with purpose. You will live with clarity. You will know exactly why you are created by the Lord. Clarity in the name of Jesus Christ.
nafukuza confusion yote kwa akili zetu. Watu wengine, they have been confused for so many years, 10, 20, 30 years, confusion. They do not know why they are here on this earth. I decree clarity, a season of clarity. From today, clarity. In the name of Jesus Christ, utajielewa. Na utaelewa kusudi lako. In the name of Jesus Christ, kujielewa na kuelewa kusudi. Receive it in Jesus' name. And I want you to decree now, open your mouth and just decree a clarity. I am clear about my vision. I am clear about my purpose. I am clear about my what I want in my life. I am clear that what I want, I am clear about God's intention in my life. I am clear. You are activating it by faith. So don't worry. Don't start getting confused here. Be clear in your intentions and be clear in your words of prayer. In the name of Jesus Christ, I'm clear. I'm clear. I'm clear. I'm clear about what I'm supposed to do. I am clear about what I am supposed to give. I am clear in the name of Jesus Christ. There is clarity of what I am supposed to do. In the name of Jesus Christ, I sabotage every confusion. I sabotage every lack of indecisiveness. In the name of Jesus Christ, you're going to be decisive and precise. In the name of Jesus Christ, that is your portion. Oh, I celebrate you, Jesus, for releasing this grace. In your grace, Mwenyezi Mungu imetupisha mbao wengi wetu. But tonight we receive clarity. I receive clarity. I receive clarity of purpose. I receive clarity of my intentions. I will know what to do. Even clarity of business, clarity of where to apply, clarity of work, clarity of promotion, clarity. Clearly, I am going to know what to do. Lord, I am going to hear a voice speaking into my ear, when to turn to the left and when to turn to the right. In the name of Jesus Christ, even when we are selecting our spouses, we are going to have clarity. Our emotions are going to be clear. Our mind is going to be clear. Those who have intuition, our intuition is going to be perfected. In the name of Jesus Christ, we are going to get it. We are going to nail it this time around. No more missing. And now I want to declare that none of us is going to miss our opportunities of elevation. In the name of Jesus Christ, no one is going to miss. We who have gathered here tonight are not going to miss opportunities. And Lord, I want to turn around some seasons. Some have declared that they have missed seasons. And Lord, you are a God of second chances. Yes. So tonight, I usher a repeat season. Rabababa Shandarari Kiriri. The season is coming again. Because Lord, you have clarified our minds. You have cleared our condition. So it is coming again. It is happening again. Thank you, Jesus. It is happening again. It is happening again. It is happening again. You're releasing fresh opportunities. You're rewinding the opportunities, oh God. And every season that we have wasted, oh God, Lord, your word says that you shall everything that we have lost, you're going to replenish. Lord, I release replenishment. I release replenishment. Mungu naitisha redemption of time. Someone just speak upon your life. The Lord to redeem your time. Lord, redeem my time. King of glory, redeem my time. Mahali Mungu niliwaste in my youthfulness. Mahali nilitupa ambao nikifanya mambo ambao hayastahili. Mungu wakati nilitupa ambao nikishughulika na mambo ya dunia. Mungu mpaka nikapoteza opportunities zangu. Jehovah Mungu ishie milele. Coming back season. Mama shandire. Redemption of time. Redemption of time. Come on, pray somebody for their redeeming of time. Lord is going to redeem our time. The Lord is going to redeem every lost time, every lost minute, every lost opportunity. Oh, I feel it in my spirit. Come on, just receive it and pray. Pray for it. Redeem my time, my Jesus. Redeem my time, my Lord. Redeem my time, King of glory. Redeem my time, Holy One of Israel. Redeem my time, King of Kings. Redeem my time, my Jesus. Redeem my time. Redeem every minute, every opportunity that I have lost. Lord, they are coming back. My seasons are coming back. My opportunities are coming back. My timings are coming back. In the name of Jesus Christ. Mimi niliyeitwa nimepoteza. Sipotezi tena. Maana unanirudishia Mwenyezi Mungu. Kwa huruma yako, kwa upendo wako, unanirejeshea.
unanirejeshea, ninalipwa. What I have been stolen, nalipwa. Tonight we are going to be paid. Some of us are going to be paid. Lost time in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Lost time. Lost time. Replenishment. I decree replenishment. I decree replenishment. Ah, wells. Redigging of our wells. Lord, you are redigging our wells tonight. You are redigging our wells, King of Glory. Like the Isaac's wells were filled up every time by the enemies, but he kept on redigging new ones. And tonight you're refreshing us, oh God. We are redigging new ones, oh God. Our lives are going to be uplifted. Our lives are being inspired again. I am being lifted up again. I'm being lifted up again. I am being lifted up. And people thought I am forgotten, but tonight I am being remembered. King of Glory, we are being remembered, King of Glory. See, our family looked down upon us, but Lord, we are getting direction. We are getting direction, King of Glory. We are getting the way. We are sasa ndio tunaelewa. Vitu tunashikanisha. Mambo tunashikanisha. Tunashikanisha Jehovah. Tunashikanisha Mungu ishe milele. Tunashikanisha Baba. Tunashikanisha. Oh, ninaelewa. Ninaelewa maisha yangu. Maisha yangu hata ni confused tena. Ninaelewa Mungu. Ninashikanisha Mungu. Ninaelewa. Rika baba sandarara. Kumbe ulitaka nikuwe hapa. Kumbe ulitaka nishikane na wewe. Kumbe ulitaka nikuwe mahali hapa. Rika baba sandarari kiriarara. Rika mama. In the name of Jesus. 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 I release. I release. Rika baba baba. Rika mama sandarari kiriarara. Thank you, King of Glory. Thank you, Master God. You are worthy. You are worthy, King of Kings. You are worthy for the seasons that you're turning around for us, oh God. You're turning around our seasons, my God. Life, I speak life upon somebody. I speak life upon my life. I speak life in every situation, that every dead situation, every dead thing. Come alive in the name of Jesus Christ. Tonight is life-giving. Tonight is life-giving. We are receiving life. Lord Jesus, this being your month of your seventh month, King of Glory, as a month of culmination, a month of perfection. Lord, perfect every one of us. Perfect us, my God. Tonight, perfect us, King of Glory. Mungu, as we spend our night with you, as we spend our midnight with you, King of Glory, perfect us, my God. Perfect us, King of Glory. We are offering everything you have given us, oh God. We are offering masomo yetu. We are offering our businesses, and now I want you to cover everything that is called by your name. I want you to give it to the Lord right now, that it may be perfected. Perfect our businesses, perfect our careers, perfect our families, perfect our children, perfect everything that is called by our names. Come on, give it to the Lord and ask him for perfection. Perfect it, King of Glory. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Oh, we pray in the spirit. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Move and perfect us, Lord. Perfect our businesses, King of Glory. Align us afresh, oh God. Align us afresh, my King. Kama tumekua tumetupa mbao, Mungu. Tulainishe, Mungu. Tonight, Lord, tunaomba kulainishwa. Lord, tuma destiny help us watusaidie kulainika. Set the right people along our way to watusaidie what we are supposed to do, King of Glory. Oh, perfect us, my God. Perfect us, King of Glory. Perfect us, Holy One of Israel. Riakama mama sandarari kiriaraba kiriaraba shandererere. Rikarama sandarari kiriaraba shandarari kiriri. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, be exalted. Be magnified, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. You are worthy. Come on, just begin to go into a place of thanksgiving. Lord, we thank you. We honor you. Thank you, Lord, for tonight. Thank you for tonight. This was my night. Lord, you intended me to be here. Oh, you purposed me to be here. That I may receive a word to turn around my season. That I may receive a word to turn around my situation. That I may receive a word, Lord, to make my life better. Every lost time, I thank you that you have redeemed it for me. Every lost opportunity, I thank you because you have redeemed it for me. Every lost situations, oh God, I thank you because you are bringing them back, King of Glory. Oh, you're bringing me back, my God. 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 Thank you, King of Glory. I thank you, my Jesus. I honor you, my God. I thank you, King of Glory. I exalt you, Holy One of Israel. Thank you, my Father. Thank you, my Daddy. Thank you, my Master. Thank you, my King. King of Glory. Ah, we surrender. We surrender everything to you. Thank you, King of Glory. Lord, your word says, let your petitions arise in thanksgiving before me. And Lord, we have lifted up ourselves in thanksgiving, knowing that you have done it for us, O God. You have moved on our behalf, O God. Lord, unatutetea. From tonight, sijitetei tena. From tonight, sijipigani tena. From tonight, sijitetei tena. Wewe ndio mtetezi wangu. You're going to speak on my behalf. You go mahali, wherever I shall stand before men, you are going to speak on my behalf. You are going to equip me with the right words, oh God. Thank you, King of Glory. Thank you, my God. Thank you, my Jesus. Thank you, Holy One of Israel. Oh, we bless you. We honor you, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. And since many of us also are believing God for spouses and true vocations, do also spend a few minutes in thanksgiving, just thanking God for that spouse. Some of you have already given me their testimonies that the spouse has manifested. So all of us, just thank God for your spouse. This is a specific one for your spouse, whether they are present, whether they are coming. Yeah, we thank you, Lord. Thank you, because it's gonna pass. Yes, I receive, and I thank you, King of Glory. Be exalted, Holy One of Israel. Be magnified.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for what you're doing. Thank you for your manifestation.
Thank you for what you're doing of our lives. Thank you for my prayer for a partner, King of Glory, and the things and the miracles that you have been doing through these prayers. Thank you, Lord, even for truth fellowship and the mighty, wonderful things you have been doing in our lives. Who would have thought you would have such a great thing for us, oh God? Lord, you are such a smart God. You're such a wise God. You're such a perfecter of things. We thank you. We honor you. We exalt you, King of Glory. And Lord, as we usher in a new day, I want to decree over everyone's day. The Lord, as the day becomes new, so shall their life become. As their day becomes new, so shall their life become.
Amen.
Refreshed life. Tonight I speak a refreshed life as you usher your new day. In the name of Jesus Christ, a refreshed life, a renewed life, a purposeful life, a life full of peace, a life full of joy, a life full of goodness, a life oozing with love and goodness, a life full of glory of God. Oh, as a new day breaks, I release a grace of goodness. I release a grace of freshness. I release a grace of favor in the name of Jesus Christ. Someone needs some favor, and they have been operating in this favor. But Lord, it is releasing you into a place of favor. In the name of Jesus Christ, you will knock that door and it shall be open, not because you have the credentials, but because the Lord is upon you. And he's favoring me. Oh, the Lord is favoring us. We thank you, honor you, we exalt you. Thank you for a new day. Come on, just thank the Lord for a new day. Lord, I thank you. I thank you. Thank you, Jesus, for Saturday. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for my weekend. Thank you, King of Glory. As I enter my seventh day, King of Glory, and a day of rest, King of Glory, be exalted, be holy. Thank you, Holy One. Thank you, King of Glory, and Lord of Lords. You are worthy.
Thank you, Jesus.
You can give him a clap offering. He's been a good God. Yeah. Don't worry. I know I have people sleeping around me, but I want to give on the Lord a clap offering.
and thank him for a beautiful prayer time. Beautiful, because my season is brand new. I'm walking into a new season. I'm walking into a new day. Oh, in Jesus' mighty name, we pray in thanksgiving.
Amen. Amen.
All glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, now, and ever
shall be. All glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, now, and ever shall be. Shall be
world without end. Amen.
All glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, now, and ever shall be. Shall be world without
end. Amen. Now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ.
And the love of God, be with us now
and forevermore. Amen.
And we bless ourselves in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
So for us who like to walk in deeper revelation, you know what to do. I have always taught you